Salutations, Celestial Sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? The term galactic neighborhood was used to describe distance when the supernova SN2014J lit up in Messier 82, and refers to galaxies that are in our general area of the universe, usually within tens of millions of light years. But what about our stellar neighborhood, such as the stars we can easily see in the night sky? Our Milky Way galaxy is generally considered to be about 100 to 120,000 light years across. Yet the vast majority of stars we can see in the night sky from a truly dark location are only about 2,000 or so light years away, and many are much closer. So what are some of the closest ones? Let's look at the southern part of the sky in winter, noting where the constellations are, but removing the stars at all distances. Now, at 15 light years, we add two stars. Sirius shines brightest in the night sky at magnitude negative 1.4, and it is only 8.6 light years away. Another is Procyon, not far from Sirius in the sky. It's the alpha star of Canis Minor, the diminutive and not terribly impressive little dog constellation to the east of Orion and north of Canis Major and Monoceros. But what is this other one off to the west? That's Epsilon Eridani. At magnitude 3.7, it's easy to overlook, or perhaps not even see, in your night sky, but it is a fairly close star at just 10.8 light years. It is one spectral class off of our sun, and may have two or more planets orbiting it, though confirmation of these planets is somewhat uncertain at this time. What if we look just a bit farther out? More on that momentarily. And now this week's dark sky fact. The International Dark Sky Association just named a dark sky reserve and a dark sky community. Check out the homepage of Eyes on the Sky this week to learn more. Looking just 30 light years out, we add quite a few more stars, and two of them are neighbors of Epsilon Eridani. Omicron 2 Eridani is only 16 light years distant, though at 4.3 magnitude, it usually takes binoculars for many of us to see. Delta is nearly 30 light years away, but at 3.5 magnitude is at the naked eye visual threshold for many of us. And it is just 5 degrees from much further away, but 3.0 magnitude Gamma Eridani, helping most of us to track it down. Between these stars and Sirius, and below Orion, is the 3.6 magnitude Gamma Leporis in Lepus the Hare. At 29 light years distance, it certainly qualifies as being in our neck of the woods, though it is 2.5 times as bright and is a spectral class up from our sun at F7. Around the same magnitude and nearly the same distance is Pi 3 Orionis in the shield section of Orion the Hunter. Now, this is a really interesting area to consider for several reasons. One is that the Greek letters that are usually assigned numbers to denote stars that are close to each other are often double or binary stars. The six Pi Orionis stars forming the shield are further apart than usual for same Greek letter stars. What's also interesting is that the distance differences compared to the brightnesses of each. Pi 3 is closest at 26 light years. Pi 1 and 2 are 120 and 194 light years distant, respectively, while Pi 4, 5, and 6 are nearly 1,000 light years or more in distance from the Earth. So the apparent magnitude of these stars to us is fairly similar, but the absolute magnitudes, particularly of the very far away ones, are intrinsically quite bright, all gleaming in the negative absolute magnitudes that would outshine Sirius. Got some clear skies, even if it's really cold? Pop outside for a few minutes this week and track down these stars naked eye or with binoculars. It won't take long, and you'll know where to find some of the closest stars to our own sun. Mars is getting higher in the sky each night, though a naked eye view with the moon will likely be best for the 18th and 19th when the moon drops by the planet and Spica. On its way towards last quarter phase by the weekend, the moon first is west of Saturn on the morning of the 21st, then east of it on the 22nd. And Venus beats the sun over the horizon by more than 2 hours in the morning now, and is still just about at peak brightness too. That's all for this week. Keep your eyes on the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.